had Mark Frohnmeyer from Arcimoto lay down a challenge to make a drive system gearbox out of solid aluminum. I got a 4.5-inch 18 by 18 piece of billet. We're getting the right tool fats, the right tools to run this machine at 100% of its absolute load. I got the HSM, the AutoCAD software for high-speed machining, and the tool paths here are amazing. And what we're doing is we're doing a constant engagement to make it so the tool doesn't keep popping up and slowing down. It just has to run fast and hard and get all the metal out in a hurry. And we gotta know that time is money. And when we start running the parts the way that the machines are capable of running them, not the way we think they're capable, but the way that they were designed to move and run, when we have that aggressiveness, that's when we're competing, that's when we're making money, and that is how America is gonna compete. All right, so I just finished programming operation number 2, so we're flipping it over, and we made a special plate that match up perfectly with this part, so as we come over, we slide it. It's like 10,000ths of an inch. It's just such a snug fit to get it over. We're locking it down, and then we're cutting it away. So I'm gonna run the simulation right now, so I can zoom in, I can see where I'm at, right over here. All right, I just wanna touch base on why I run certain parts dry and why I run certain parts with coolant. The simple reason, I wanna show the audience exactly how the machine is cutting the material so you can see the chips popping off and see how awesome machining truly is. So the tool's right here and it's finishing. You see all the 5 axes working. Just cut all the grooves on the side of the Arcimoto gear housing. Creating the bores. Right now, chips are just popping off, popping off. I can see exactly where my tool's going and making sure that it doesn't go somewhere it's not supposed to go.
I keep my spindle low down, keeping the heat out of the aluminum so it doesn't heat up, melting the aluminum to the tool, which would break the tool and cause damage to the machine.
Part looks awesome. Looks like everything worked perfectly. Ooh, absolutely perfect.
Yeah, I think it's pretty much on the money.
Get this thing delivered up to Oregon. Make it happen. Woo! Good job, man.
Well, welcome to Arcimoto.
Well, I saw the car coming in, so this is like version 4.
So yeah, right? this is our 4th generation prototype. It was really to prove out the platform. The vision for the company is to develop a vehicle that anybody can afford and drive.
Wow. Yeah. Matches the blue on the Arcimoto logo.
Perfect.
Yeah. I got the picture. We tried to match it, and hopefully it came out to the specs that you guys are calling out.
TITAN, quite often when we're talking to people about this vehicle, you know, we'll refer to it almost as like Model T meets laptop.
How do we get you from point A to point B, but do it in a radically different, more efficient way?
Wait, that's my part right there.
That's it?
That is beautiful.
You guys did a great job.
Wow.
It really is the backbone of the drivetrain. Both motors mount to that single gearbox chassis. This is that last keystone piece of the whole product. And it is a very compact dual motor gearbox that splits the torque out to the two wheels. The idea of sustainable transportation only works if people can buy the products. You can own a fully electric vehicle that takes you around on all of your daily driving trips, is incredibly fun to drive, can go on the freeway, can go on the expressway, and it sets you back 12 grand.
I am so amazed at this vehicle that you made right here in Eugene, Oregon. It's just an incredible thing.
With the continuing falling in price of automation, it just makes more sense to bring production here versus shipping it all overseas. So if we want to actually really rebuild America's middle class, it's going to require actually building things here domestically.
Good paying jobs year round, rain, snow, or sunshine, and you can manufacture products doing it right here.
The idea that we're somehow just a nation of consumers, I think, is really misses the point that we are a nation of builders.
Absolutely. hats off to you, everything, for just doing it right here, putting people to work right here in Eugene, Oregon. Great job.
Right. Thanks, man. When TITAN came up with a part that was exactly right the first time, it's that kind of relationship that actually allows us to succeed.
Arcimoto, American build, right here in Eugene,